everybody, and welcome. I'm Osiris Frost. In today's episode, I want to discuss something that CIG has been teasing for the past couple of weeks, cargo decks. If we look at the card for the cargo decks currently on the roadmap for 3.11, it reads as follows. Facilities within rest stops where players can handle all their cargo needs from dropping off and picking up, buying new cargo equipment, and taking on cargo-related missions. Now, in some recent episodes of Star Citizen Live and Inside Star Citizen, they delved into greater detail. Let's take a look.
The cargo module interiors we first saw concepts for 2 weeks ago have moved into white box phase as they look to expand the gameplay opportunities for cargo haulers everywhere, with new contracts, new opportunities, and eventually tie-in functionality with the upcoming player trading app, which when used together will facilitate the transfer of commodities and such between players.
How will cargo decks differ from normal commodity screens?
We also wanted people to be able to store cargo, and this is kind of where it gets into the player trading app. We, you know, if you have a large bit of cargo, large items, things like that, that you'd want to trade to somebody else, you'd have to go to a cargo deck in your location, store it there, the trade ownership to the other person can come pick it up from that location. Right. Kind of a location that we're trying to put into stations, so it would just be a deck that's somewhere in the station that you can take an elevator to and go and start dealing with the stuff there. So, and I would expect these things to kind of get inserted into like starports or things like that too. We haven't really discussed exactly where they're going to go in the major landing zones yet, but Certainly needs to be a part of it.
Yeah, I'll say it. That's way better than the Bandu Merchant Man. Well, put away the pitchforks and torches, okay? I can sense your outrage, but just hear me out. The main draw to the BMM, the thing that sets it apart from other cargo ships, is the fact that it can perform retail commerce wherever it happens to be, with its onboard shops. The fact that it can take its business right down to the planet's surface and do business right then and there. You can buy whatever you want, and then it can be off to the next spot. Now, the only other ship right now in Star Citizen, as of this recording, that has that functionality is the Drake Kraken Privateer, and given the astronomical price tag of that ship, I think it's safe to say that hardly anybody is ever going to own one of those ships. Now, if, as was just discussed in that video we just watched, cargo decks are envisioned as having the capacity for you to drop off and store cargo and then allow other players to come later on at their convenience and purchase that cargo, then this is tantamount to the shopping functionality of the BMM and the Kraken Privateer. In fact, in some respects, it's even better because this allows buyers the flexibility to go to your cargo deck at their convenience when they have the money and the cargo capacity and the right ship to do the sort of business that they want to do. They don't have to have that all lined up in advance when you happen to show up in your BMM. Now, there's a lot to unpack in this argument and the points I'll be making. So first, I wanted to kind of set some parameters and differentiate between two broad categories of consumer goods, and that's bulk cargo and retail goods. For the reasons that I'm about to discuss, I think that cargo decks are going to have a massive advantage over ships, over retail cargo ships, when it comes to the buying and selling of bulk cargo, and in some cases, retail goods as well. And I'll explain. All right, so the first advantage that jumps right to my mind is if you're warehousing your goods in a cargo deck, that's going to be very secure. Think of the station security automated defenses, the turrets that will shoot at anybody with a crime stat. If somebody comes and tries to rip you off, you're going to have station security, which never gets tired, never has to log off, never gets wife aggro. It's going to be there 24/7, and it's going to shoot at anybody who tries to take your stuff. Yeah, you're probably going to have to pay some sort of small fee to rent the space, but I'm sure, given the convenience to the buyer, that this will definitely be made up for in the amount of commerce that you do. Number two, if you deposit goods at this retail location to be bought and sold at the convenience of buyers, you can be out in the verse using your ship, which is now emptied of cargo, to be picking up and transporting other cargo. So you're actually able to effectively have two cargo holds at once, one in a physical permanent location where people can come and go and do business, and then the second with your ship, which you can take anywhere you want based on market conditions and transport whatever goods are profitable at that time. Now, all of that said, I'm going to go out on a limb here and say something that's even more controversial, and that's that the Banu Merchantman's ability to come to where you are and bring the retail to you is widely misunderstood by the Star Citizen community to be a strength, when in fact, I believe it is a pretty big weakness, and I'll explain why. Now, think about it. Everybody who plays this game is going to have at least a starter ship. They're going to have the ability to come to your cargo deck when it makes sense. People are mobile and itinerant. They like to go out and shop. This is not going to be a problem for anyone. Conversely, if you are dependent on people being able and willing to buy what you happen to have on your ship at the time you and they are in physical proximity to each other, there are going to be many situations when they can't accommodate that wish. And it's going to be a very common thing, I find, for Banu Merchantman pilots to fly all the way out to the ass end of the galaxy to some, you know, refinery or somebody's little outpost, hoping to sell all this stuff and not even making enough money to pay for the fuel it took to get out there. On the flip side, if you have the cargo deck, again, you don't have to be there. You can be doing whatever you want to do, drop off your cargo there to be sold when it's convenient to you, and your customers can come to the cargo deck with or without you when it's convenient for them, with the money and with the cargo capacity to take away the goods that they want to buy from you. This is a much better, much more reliable business model than pretending to play Jawa and hoping that people want to buy whatever junk you're porting around the galaxy. Now, I think I've beat up on this ship quite enough. There is one area in which the Banu Merchantman, I feel, will excel, and that is Nullsec commerce. Now, if you think about the people who are going to live in places like Pyro and Nyx, etc., Outlaw Systems, these people are probably largely going to have crime stat. They're going to be unable to go to civilized UE space and be serviced by retail outlets there. Companies like Bering and Aegis Dynamics and so forth are not going to want to do business with known criminals. That creates a market opportunity for a middleman. That's where the Banu Merchantman is going to shine, is essentially fencing goods to criminals. And, you know, I don't think I'm contradicting myself here. I'm not saying that you're going to go to where the criminal's outpost is. I think that there's going to be a few major nodes like Spider or Ruined Station and so forth, where you can go with your Banu Merchantman on a reliable schedule, you can announce the goods you're going to have, and you can bring those things which are not going to be provided. Based on the video we just watched, cargo depots are going to be in major landing zones, they're going to be in space stations. Those aren't going to be in Outlaw space, those are going to be in UEE space. So that really creates the market opportunity for the Merchantman to go to the major pirate hubs and do business there. People are going to need to buy ammunition and parts to repair and restock and rearm and refit their ships that they just can't go to Cryastro, you know? They can't go to Garrity Defense or live fire weapons on Port Alisar without getting arrested. The moral of the story is the Banu Merchantman is really going to excel as a, I don't want to say a pirate ship, but a ship whose crew is going to primarily service the outlaw community. All right. So let me know what you think about all that down in the comments below. And if you haven't already, be sure to like this video, subscribe to this channel, and hit the notification bell for future video updates. Once again, I've been Osiris Frost. Thanks for watching.